When I first started exhibiting symptoms of Parkinson's, I was in huge denial. Just said, it can't be me. That's not possible. The most visible symptom was my trembling. It was in my right arm only. But, you know, somebody could look at me and see that there was something wasn't quite right. I sense there are times when I cannot, with medication, cannot control the tremors.
Mr. Jonna was experiencing what a number of patients with Parkinson's will experience. Early in their course, they will respond very well to medications. Over time, the Parkinson's disease will progress and the medications become less effective. This is when deep brain stimulation is really of great benefit.
Apparently, I didn't realize this, but deep brain stimulation has been around for quite a few years, over 30 years. So they have a pretty good success rate. The primary benefit that was stressed to me was the control of the tremors.
Deep brain stimulation is a procedure where electrodes are placed into very precise locations within the brain that are known to control circuitry that we want to modify. Normally, we place electrodes into the brain, and then those are connected to a generator that is implanted under the skin and the chest, and that helps to moderate those abnormal signals in the brain to try and restore more normal function. Well, we were just getting the system connected back there, so it looks like we've got everything all good to go.
That's great. When Dr. Yara talked about the different options that were available to me, she told me that they did MRI surgery, which allowed them to put me to sleep during the surgery, which was my preference. Some people want to be awake. I didn't want any part of it. We'll see how that works out.
Today we're using the MRI to directly guide us very precisely in real time with imaging to align the device that will help us get the electrodes to the right spot and then place those electrodes. Unfortunately, we don't have the answer to slowing down Parkinson's disease. So by controlling the symptoms, by not having him be such a slave to whether a dose of his medication helps or not, by getting better tremor control, that allows him to live a more natural life that we all want to have, a more comfortable life. And that's the main goal of this procedure.
Hello.
Hey, Carrie, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. I think in general, the uncontrolled movements have been mitigated significantly.
So it's actually better. How about open and close? How does that feel? I mean, that's pretty good range of motion.
It is.
Very comfortable.
So Frank tolerated his stimulation very well. He had very minimal side effects. If he did, they were very intermittent. They would come and then just last a few seconds and go away. And his lead placement looked very good. He did have improvements. His took a little bit more stimulation to get the full benefit. So he still had some breakthrough symptoms, but I still think he had quite a bit of improvement and he was happy with what he got for today.
I've noticed a significant reduction in tremors. I mean, he still has them, but not nearly as he did before. I did notice that he's walking up a little straighter than he used to. He's not as hunched over.
The whole family is excited because our youngest daughter, Brianna, is getting married. I want to be there in every way she needs me, dancing and enjoying the celebration. I looked at it as you can let the disease run over you, or you can try to be able to fight it off as much as possible. I think with the professional team that we have here at Henry Ford, the risk is minimal, and I'm willing to take that risk to get the desired result, which I'm confident I will have.